I am here with Bellator 206 competitor Jeremiah Labiano. Jeremiah, these are pretty exciting times for you. How are you?
What's up, Matt? Hey, thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Anytime, anytime. Bellator 206, September 29th in California. How does it feel to finally be returning to the cage?
Oh, man, it's awesome. I mean, I was actually supposed to fight in May when Bellator was out here in San Jose. I was actually slated to fight James Gallagher, but he ended up pulling out when he got, I guess he got cut on, under his eye. So that little scar he got under his eye. So he ended up pulling out again. That's twice on me. And then he ended up moving to bantamweight last week, 2 weeks ago. And he ended up getting what he deserved.
You know, man, I have to say, I really didn't expect that outcome. I didn't see him getting knocked out like that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know much about that Ricky guy, but, I mean, shit, 11-1, and, I mean, I checked out his record and stuff, too. He's a pretty legit guy. So, I mean, James hasn't really fought anyone that was really legit. I mean, I guess the Machida guy, but there's only one Machida, Loyota.
Yeah. So, James Gallagher, if that match were to ever be available again, would that be a match that still interests you?
Oh, of course. Of course.
You see yourself getting a finish against him as well?
Oh, of course. Put a burden on him.
Yeah. Well, that would certainly be a great fight, man. Talking about this upcoming fight for you, you'll be taking on a pretty savvy veteran, Justin Smitley. He's definitely fought some pretty tough guys in the past. Talk a little bit about him.
He's fought a lot of veterans and stuff, so, I mean, he hasn't been very active within the past couple. He hasn't been active since 2016. I mean, I'm not looking past that or anything. You know, anyone's dangerous, especially if he fought, you know, top little guys, the guys that are, you know, now in the UFC. You know, I definitely take all my fights serious and stuff like that, and this is nothing different.
Mm. Now, is there anything kind of within his game that kind of sticks out to you?
In his game?
Yeah.
I mean, he's mainly a stand-up guy. I mean, he does do a little grappling and stuff like that. But I mean, you know, we've been studying him and stuff. He's been around for a while, so I've seen him on the local fight scene and things like that. So, I mean, you know, everyone has holes in their games, and you know, we've been doing a lot of, you know, watching tape and everything like that, and you know, putting our game plan together of what we're gonna do for that fight. So.
Now, I usually hate asking this question, but give me a prediction. How does this fight end?
Oh, man. I'm just happy with a win, man. I'm not going to talk no shit or say I'm going to finish him, I'm going to do this, do that. But, you know, I'm working hard. I've been working hard since May. I've been waiting to fight since May, so I've never really taken any time off from the gym. So, you know, I'm in there every day working hard. You know, if I'm not training, I'm teaching and I'm still learning. And so,
of course. I mean that is obvious. You have been training very, very hard for this fight and the fight you were supposed to have. Talk a little bit about your preparation for this fight. How have you been training for him?
Oh, man, we train. We do a little mixture of everything. You know, different days. You know, sometimes we'll do Muay Thai, a lot of grappling. I mean, I'm a jiu-jitsu based guy, so we work grappling every day. So, I mean, we do our strength and conditioning 3 times a week. I'm training 6 to 7 days a week. If I'm not in the gym, I'm out doing something. I'm either running, I'm either riding. I actually just rode like 40 miles a day. Is my bike in the back seat right there. So,
wow.
If I'm not in the gym, I'm definitely active doing something. So,
did you say 40 miles?
Yeah, 40 miles. I've taken up cycling for probably the past year now. So I do anywhere from 30 to 50 miles, and I'm doing like anywhere from 3,800 feet to 6,000 feet of climbing as well.
My goodness, dude, I can't even climb up the stairs in the morning.
Yeah, so it just kind of, you know, it kind of gives me time to kind of meditate and stuff like that, and, you know, just not think of, you know, the fight, just kind of relax. It's my relaxed time, but at the same time, you know, I'm working and stuff. So.
Of course. So obviously that biking, that mountain climbing would pretty much help with your mentality, you know, your mental state, but I would think it would also help with your cardio and stuff like that. That is crazy.
Oh, of course. Yeah. You know, I always try to do a little recovery ride and try to go slow, but I'm always, you know, out there competing with myself all the time. We got, you know, you turn on that Strava app and you see your past times, and you're always out there. I'm always out there trying to beat my times and stuff. So, You know, I'm PRing every week. Every time I hop on that bike, I'm getting faster. So, I guess in theory, that means my legs are getting stronger. My cardio is getting better. So,
yeah. Awesome, man. Good for you, man. That sounds pretty cool. So, briefly talking about your most recent fight, Bellator 188, you took on another tough opponent, Noad Lahat. Pretty much, what did you take away from that fight? Because you did hit him. You definitely had your highlights in that fight.
For sure. He's a veteran. He's fought in the UFC. He's, he just fought. Even though he lost, he fought Darren Caldwell. Really good guy. I just working on everything that, you know, the mistakes that I made in the fight. Definitely should have worked harder to kind of get taken down, but I just didn't really care. I didn't really care if I went to the floor or anything like that. And even if you go back and look at the fights and see the damage that he did when I was on my back, he didn't touch me. He didn't touch me at all. So, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, when you fight an Israeli guy in Israel, I mean, you can't let it go to the judge's scorecard. And unfortunately, that's what happened. And, that was my fault on that part. So, Yep, that's pretty much it. I mean, can't leave it up to the judges.
I got you, man. Well, it was definitely a great fight. We'd love to see a rematch in the near future. So, pretty much this fight's going to be in California. So, it's pretty much going to be in your backyard. California's a really big state. But your friends, your family, I'm sure, is going to be there. Does that kind of add on any extra pressure for you, or does that kind of give you that motivation, that confidence?
Oh, man, I never feel any pressure. Come on, man. I fought an Israeli guy in Israel. telling me I'm going to die. There's no pressure, man. There's no pressure. So, you know, I'm also fighting alongside one of my friends and teammates, Nacho Ortiz. He's doing his second pro fight in Bellator and stuff. And, you know, he's looking good too. And, you know, we're just going to go out there. We're going to bring a big crowd out there. And, you know, we're just going to show out that night.
It's definitely going to be great. Really, really excited for that card. So the main event and the co-main event, headlining your card, are two incredible, incredible fights. You got Gegard Mousasi versus Rory McDonald. Who do you think takes that one?
That's a tough one, man. That's a tough one. I've always been a Rory McDonald fan. So, I mean, I'm riding with Rory McDonald on this one.
Yeah. I mean, Rory McDonald, the UFC, even in Bellator, he's just so technically sound. Like, he's one of those guys who measures every single shot before he throws it. Really an incredible fighter. Gegard Mousasi, I mean, I'm sure you've seen his game. He's pretty incredible himself.
Yeah, Mousasi's good too. I've been watching him since Strikeforce days. So, you know, he's a tough gamer too. Tough guy. He's a gamer. It's going to be a really good fight.
Rampage versus Wanderlei Silva. That's a fight that I think the world should be excited for.
Yeah.
Oh, who takes that?
I'm riding with Vanderlei, man. Riding with Vanderlei. Yeah. So, well, you know, they're both old school guys. They're both OGs in the cage and stuff like that. But, you know, I think Vanderlei is gonna take this one.
Yeah, it will definitely be close. Just to make it interesting, I think I'll take Rampage. But in the back of my mind, I'm pretty sure Vanderlei is gonna take this one though. Yeah. Well, for your fans, Jeremiah, for people gonna be watching it online, like myself, what are, you know, pretty much what are the fans going to see from you come fight night?
Man, you know, every fight that I have is exciting. So, you know, they're definitely going to see an exciting fight. Don't miss it. We're just going to have a good night.
Perfect. Perfect. I am kind of curious about this, Jeremiah. So after a fight, you've definitely had your fair share of wins. You've had a pretty lengthy career. How do you celebrate a win? Because I know training camps are really hectic.
I used to party all the time, you know, back when I was first starting and stuff. So I don't know. So it's kind of hard to say. It's kind of hard to say. And it also depends, because sometimes on these Bellator cards, sometimes you end up fighting after the main event, and sometimes it already gets, like, you know, super late. And, you know, you think you want to party, but, you know, after fighting all night, and you just get tired and stuff. You just kind of want to chill. So I don't know if I'm going to keep it low key, if I'm going to go out there and, you know, do my thing.
Well, we shall find out. Bellator 206, September 29th in California. Jeremiah, thank you for your time. The floor is yours. Anyone you'd like to thank?
Everyone that just out there supports me, you know, be out there, support your local fighters and stuff, you know. It's a big event. We have it in the Bay Area. You know, we do have a few shows in the Bay Area and stuff like that. But, you know, it's very important for, you know, all the fans, all the MMA fans to come out there and support everyone, because, you know, it's a very small community and stuff like that. All you guys that support me. Love you guys all.